What's going on, guys? It's Isaac here, back again with a brand new YouTube video, and today we're going to be customizing this plain white denim jacket right here, and I'm going to be showing you guys how to turn a basic jacket like this into a crazy customized piece today. This is the first piece that I'm ever going to be customizing. We're going to be going for kind of a yin-yang theme, kind of like balance-ish. Let's get into it. All right, the tools we're going to be using today is this switchblade right here with a serrated edge. Any serrated blade will work. It's just so we can get into the denim and customize it with different kinds of distressing. We have this nail file right here that we're going to use to put on aging and wear around different parts of the jacket. We have this black pen that we can use to go around and outline the design. There's also this black Sharpie that we have that we're going to use to trace all the different things after we've done it with the pen. Then to top this all off, we have the black acrylic paint that we're going to be using on the jacket, and I really just can't wait to do this, so let's get right into it. As you guys can see, we're using the file right now to add wear into the front pockets of the jacket. Then we go straight forward into using this knife. Now, if you guys plan on doing this at home, as you can see, I'm not wearing gloves, but I do suggest doing that, because if you don't, then this can happen, and that was not fun. So right here, we got the gloves, and we're going in, adding this super distressed pattern to the jacket right now, and I'm just gonna let the rest of this footage roll, and you guys can see it when it's on the finished product. As we move on to the next step, we're putting this down under the jacket so that way our distressing doesn't go through to the other side of the jacket. Basically, what we're going to be doing in these next clips up here is using a straight edge to cut through the pencil lines that we put onto the jacket, and then use sandpaper to go across them and add the different kinds of distressing. The distressing does tend to come out best if you use it in a pattern where you go from small lines to larger lines, back down to smaller lines, so that way it looks like a more natural distressing pattern. Now I'm going to let the rest of these clips roll, and I hope you guys enjoy the footage. Alright, we just finished distressing the jacket. We're gonna do a quick pan of it so we can show you guys how it's coming out so far. Now that all the distressing is done, it is time for us to start sketching and painting the rest of this jacket.
In this step right here, we're just going to be outlining the yin yang and cutting out the stencil. There's also some footage of me painting the symbol. Unfortunately, the camera did cut before I finished, but you get the gist of it. Right now, I'm just going to be going over this sketch right here with some pen to make the stencil a little bit darker, and then we're going to get right into painting it. This symbol right here on the sleeve is actually the Buddhist symbol for balance. At this point, I'm just going around the symbol and adding a little bit more paint to details that didn't get quite filled in when I was going over the symbol the first time. Then we're gonna transition right over to me painting this symbol right here, which is the vector symbol for balance. This symbol, out of all of them, took the longest amount of time to paint. It took me a couple of hours to go in there and get all the details and then go back in and finish all the detailing. Thank you. Now we're moving to the final step. I'm just going to be painting text above the symbol. And with that being said, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I'm just going to be showing you guys how this jacket looks on body.